A very warm welcome to all my dear students. Today we are going to discuss about Unit 1, that is from the SEM 2 of English 1, The World Around Us. In this unit, we are going to discuss about water. See, water, the world around us, we see many things around us. Plants, animals, human beings, trees, and we can see sun, moon, and see in this we all need, like a human being, plants, animals, we all need water to survive, and water is the basic needs. Without water we cannot live, and in this topic we are going to discuss about water. So now let us begin with our unit 1, The World Around Us. Unit 1, The World Around Us. Activity 1. See, they have given over here one activity. Let us read it. Read the puzzle, discuss it with your partner and guess the answer. So let us read this puzzle and guess the answer. It can float, fly or fall. Is found on the earth, in the ocean and the sky. In what I eat and drink. In fact, in every part of me. It's the most needed, most wasted and most common substance on the earth. Available for a price and for free. It is worshipped and feared. It is life-giving and also causing death. It is, see what it is, can you guess? Yes, it's water. Today we are going to learn about water and discuss about the uses and how much water is important for us. In the activity 2, in class 6 you did some activities related to water on earth. Let's read some more about water. See there, this poster you can see over here, the picture. Save water, save life and save the world. Nice one, madam. So you can save, if you will save the water, you will save the world. Water for humans. Water is the basic components. See, component is what is a part which combines with other parts to form something bigger. So this water is a basic components of each cells and they are essential for our existence. For our living, water is needed. It keeps our body temperature at 36.8 degrees Celsius. See, at what degree temperature, body temperature it keeps water? 36.8 degrees Celsius. And they form the part of blood. See how, what they form? Part of blood. And they also help to carry oxygen and nutrients to our cells. See, nutrients is what any substance which plants or animals need in order to live and to grow. So all these nutrients which is needed in our body, so they help to carry oxygen and nutrients to our cells, and they remove the waste material from our body. See, in this way, it helps us. Water keeps us clean and healthy. See, water also keeps us clean and healthy. We take regularly bath, it keeps us clean. We use water to cook food, wash utensils, clean different things, water the plants and flush the toilet. See, this all are, why do we use the water in our daily life? See, we use water in our day-to-day life also in cooking food, washing utensils, and we use in the different things also to water the plant, flush in the toilet, etc. And see, we also use it for recreation, for enjoyment, recreation moment, like swimming, sailing and fishing. We use water over there. Water is very essential. See, it is very basic need and it's very essential for us. A person can survive without food for more than 30 days. See, it is said over here that a person can survive. See, we can survive without food. If we have not eaten for more than 30 days, we can survive. But less than a week without water. But we cannot survive without water. If we don't drink for 3-4 days, so we won't be able to survive. We need water. We use water for many things in our day-to-day life. And see, water is very needful. We need water for different things in our day-to-day life. See, why is water essential for existence? See, water is also essential for existence. Why? Because it's a basic component of each cell. So that's why water is very important important in our life. Now next we will see is the water for agriculture. See, water for agriculture, we use water as much as in 10 meters deep. See how much water we use for agriculture. It is said over here that 10 meters deep, 100 meters wide. See, deep is how much? 10 meters, and 100 meter is wide. And 7.1 million kilometers in length. See how much is in the length? 7.1 million kilometers in length. See, long enough to encircle the globe 180 times. See, it is explained over here. The length is how much? The long enough it is to encircle whole globe. It is 180 times that. To produce food for today's world population every year. See, in this, see, we use this much of water is being used for agriculture. Why? To produce the food that we need for our today's world's population. Whatever the population is there, every year this much water is being used in for agriculture. See how much water, if they ask how much water do we use for agriculture for today's world population, then we use as in 10 meters deep water, 100 meters wide, and 7.1 million kilometers long volume of today's world population every year, this much water. Now the next we'll see is the water habitat for animals and plants. See, habitat means water. Habitat, the natural environment in which an animal or plant usually lives. From a small fresh water pond to the vast Pacific Ocean. See, the small pond is there, and when we compare to the vast Pacific Ocean, almost every water body is found on earth is an important habitat for plants and animals. See, whichever water body is there on our earth, whichever are found water bodies that have been found on earth is very important for living habitat, natural environment for this plants and animals. Life begin in water, and even today half the world's creation live underwater. See, here it is said life begins in water. See, life begins with this water only. And even today when we see that the half the world's creation like they live underwater, like fishes, different kind of fishes are, water plants are, they live underwater. And see, now if it has been asked how is water an important habitat for the world's creation. See, life begin in water, and even today half the world's creation live underwater. And so we can say that the water is an important habitat for the world's creation. And now moving to the next one, water for industry and power production. See where water has been used for the industries and power production. Almost all industrial units use either in the production or disposal of byproducts. See, all the industries are there. All the industrial units are there. They use water. Why? How they use either in the production, for production uses they use, or for the disposal, means throwing away the things of byproducts all. So this way they use water. And this is one of the main reason why industrial belts have developed along the river banks. See why we see mostly the industries that have been belts, they have developed along the river bank. This is the main reason. So they can use the water and dispose it out, the byproducts in it. So this is the main reason why industries have developed along the river banks. And what is water is also important component in power production. See, water is important for the power production. River water is used to produce hydroelectricity. See, the water which comes from the river, it is used for produce hydroelectricity. You all might be knowing what is the meaning of hydroelectricity. See, hydroelectricity is the production of electricity by the force of fast moving water. When it moves faster, water such as river or any waterfalls, it moves very fast and they produce hydroelectricity by building dams and through thermal power plants. See, thermal means connected with the heat. They have been hydrated by hydroelectricity is being produced by building dams also and through thermal power plants also. So in this we discussed about how the water is used for human being, for us, for agriculture, for plants and animals, for industries and power production. Now let us move ahead. Now in this activity 4, what is said over here in the activity 4? Here are some ways you can use water or misuse it. Talk to your friend and put them in appropriate columns. See, the different they have given different ways where we use water and misuse the water, and you have to segregate them into do's and don'ts. So now let us discuss about all the do's. I'll read the sentence and tell you where it will come in the do or don't. Use only as much water as you require. Yes, that is do. Close the tap tightly after use. Yes, we should close the tap. That is do. We should do it. Use a bucket while bathing instead of shower. Yes, we should use bucket because wastage of water will be less. So we use bucket while bathing. That will come in the do. Throw garbage near water sources when on picnic. No, that is for don'ts. We should not throw garbage near water sources because it will harm water sources and it will spoil it. Organize tree plantation activities. Yes, we should organize. That is in the do. Form a group of people and discuss ways of conserving water. See, this is also it comes in the form a group and discuss way of conserving water. That is do's. Throw puja offering into river or ponds nearby. No, don't. We should not throw puja offerings into river or pond nearby because it make it dirty water. The next is wash your vehicles in the river or ponds. Don'ts. We should not wash up vehicles in the rivers or pond. Use a water jug instead of running water while brushing teeth. Yes, that is do's. We should use a water jug instead of running water while when we are brushing our teeth. This was all about what should we do and what should we not do. Now in this activity, activity 5, work with your partner and list your daily activities where energy, electricity is used directly or indirectly. See how we should discuss with our friends and we should note down the things, activities where electricity is used directly or indirectly. See, in this direct use is given and indirect. For example, I'll give you some examples of direct use. See, use of fan, use of light, use of washing machine, use of iron, use of vehicles, use of heater, use of air conditioner. See, all these are direct use. And which are the indirect use of electricity? Food we eat, toys for children. In this energy, indirect use of energy, it is clothes we wear, cosmetic we use, building we build, books we read, shoes we wear, furniture we use. See, all these were the indirect use. I hope you have understood till here all the activities, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 activities. And in the next part, we will discuss ahead. Thank you.